The group of Japanese billionaire Kazuo Okada insists it is the legitimate board of the Okada Manila Resort and Casino. This after a statement from a rival group, Tiger Resort Asia, warned the public against transacting with the present board of Tiger Resort Leisure and Entertainment. That board is composed of Okada, Tony Boy Guwango, and Dindo Espeleta. TRAL also says it owns 99.99% of the shares in TRLEI. But Okada's camp says TRAL's statement was an attempt to undermine the authority and jurisdiction of the Philippine Supreme Court. It again cited the High Court status quo ante order, which it said led to Okada being reinstated as board chairman. The Japanese businessman played a leading role in developing, managing, and promoting Okada Manila. But he was ousted from TRLEI's board in 2017 over an allegedly anomalous $17 million loan. And a new survey shows controlling in the increase of prices of basic goods is the urgent national concern among Filipinos. Based on the survey of Okta Research Group, 52% of the respondents wants government to address the issue of rising prices of goods. 43% wants a wage hike, while some are calling for affordable prices of rice, vegetables, and meat. The survey was conducted back in March, but Okta Research says bringing down prices of goods remains an important matter, and the incoming Marcos administration should prioritize addressing it. With 2 weeks left in office, President Rodrigo Duterte again defends his bloody war on drugs. He says it's not true there were extrajudicial killings in the government's campaign against illegal drugs, adding that he did not order a shooting spree against drug addicts. Duterte maintains he only directed law enforcers to kill drug suspects who threatened their lives during operations. Data from the Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency show more than 6,000 people have been killed during anti-illegal drugs operations since July 1, 2016. But the ABS-CBN Investigative and Research Group's number is slightly higher at 7,009 deaths, based on data released by local officials and information reported by news outlets.
Yung sinasabi nila, extrajudicial killing, hindi totoo yan. Why do you have to extrajudicial kill a person? May order to the law enforcement agencies is that go out and destroy the apparatus of the drug syndicates. And if you have to kill because you are in danger of being killed, go ahead, unahan mo na. Do not hesitate. And I said, I take full legal responsibility.
Duterte also criticized a former Supreme Court justice who described his bloody drug war as unconstitutional, saying the magistrate was out of touch with the realities on the ground. In an interview on Rappler, former Supreme Court Associate Justice Antonio Carpio had said the drug war was clearly unconstitutional after the National Police directed its personnel to neutralize drug suspects under Operation Tokham.
How many dysfunctional families are suffering? Kayo nga. Sige daw, how do you solve? Human rights. Pati yan, justice is unconstitutional. If it's unconstitutional, so be it. I will do it. Wala akong, I don't give a pinatay ni Duterte, yan. Para sa akin, yung human carcass ka lang.
The Philippine Commission on Human Rights said in its latest report that the government's drug war failed to uphold human rights and even encouraged a culture of impunity for the killings. Last year, the International Criminal Court also authorized a full inquiry into the government's drug war due to possible crimes against humanity, but that was suspended as the court assesses the government's deferral request.